Well, here in the Sunshine State, we hear about the dangers of skin cancer and the importance of using sun protection outside. But according to the National Cancer Institute, only a third of American adults regularly wear sunscreen. And for men under 50, the risk of developing melanoma, the deadliest form of skin cancer, is greater than any other type of cancer. And here to explain why and to discuss prevention and treatment is Dr. Josue Lutzky, oncologist with Mount Sinai Medical Center in Miami, and melanoma survivor Richard Wing. Thank you both for joining us.
Good afternoon.
Thank you both.
Nice to be here.
So, Richard, was skin cancer even on your radar?
No, it wasn't. I had noticed a little bump on my head, on my scalp, that grew pretty quickly. In about 2.5 weeks, it went from BB size to P size. And I had my wife also monitoring it and its growth. And when we when we wound up coming down to Miami, we found a dermatologist who specialized in skin cancer rather than wrinkle-free stuff.
Right.
And we got to see him, and he did a biopsy. And a couple weeks later, when we were over in Bimini, we wound up getting an email that said, call me, and we did. And he said, don't call 911 or an ambulance, he said, but don't wait until March to get back to Miami, because I did have melanoma. And he wound up being my advocate and helping to set up a same-day procedure for a PET scan to find out where the hot spots were, and also then to get to see Dr. Lutzky. Found out that I had 4 hot spots. I had tumors on my liver, my lungs, my right shoulder, and one in my brain. Wound up taking care of the one in the brain with gamma knife surgery in South Miami. And then when that was completed, I was able to get onto a clinical trial that was for immunotherapy. And I had to be back down in Miami every 3 weeks for 2 years. And that's the path that we went on, and it was quite successful.
I was going to say, but what shocking news. I mean, when a doctor tells you that, you know, the cancer's already spread, how do you cope with something like that?
First thing, be sure that you still keep a positive attitude and come at it as a project. It'll give you a little distance and let you to have some objectivity about what's going on. And I didn't really freak out when I was told that I had cancer. The first thing that I really did was to reflect on my life. And at that time, I was already 70 years old, and I've had a wonderful life and a great family. So I put that into perspective and didn't think about the bad parts. And I was very hopeful that this would work, and it certainly did.
Doctor, do you hear this story often where, you know, somebody just notices something small, but it turns out to be a lot more serious?
Yes, sometimes melanoma, which can be quite advanced, may be manifested by very small external features. That's not usually the case, though. More often people will have an initial melanoma that will be treated, treated with surgery, and then sometimes several years later or less, the disease may reappear in different organs.
What do you want people to know about melanoma that we don't, and especially the risk for men?
Yeah, so many things I want people to know about melanoma. I don't think we have enough time here to go over those, but let me think of the most important ones. Number one is what we already know, but we often forget, is that the main cause of melanoma is exposure to ultraviolet light, sun exposure, particularly in childhood and as it continues throughout life. So that's the first thing we need to avoid. We need to avoid behaviors that also lead to increased exposure, like tanning beds.
So tanning beds are a no-no.
Tanning beds should be a no-no, especially because they're used mostly by younger people, teenagers, young adults, and really at a time where they're more susceptible to developing these issues later in life.
We're seeing some ways to prevent skin cancer. One of the things that we have up there at the very top is seek the shade, especially between those peak hours,
right,
10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
Right.
Not burning, covering up. Sunscreen,
Yeah.
A lot of people say, well, you know what, I'm not laying out, I'm not going in the sun, but you would say every day, everybody.
I would say to use sunscreen in the exposed areas every day, on the face, on the extremities. Just walking from the parking lot to your office and back can add up over time. You do want to use sunscreen when you're going to predict you're going to be exposed to the sun, particularly in those peak hours, as you mentioned. There are now several products, several fabrics that have SPF number that will protect you. Also, if you don't like the feeling of sunscreen, yeah, you can wear some of this gear that's actually very helpful. Very important is a hat. People wear caps and they forget that a cap will not protect their ears and the posterior part of their neck, and those are very common areas for skin cancer in general, as well as melanoma. So a wide brim hat or one of those Foreign Legion hats with a flap, those should be worn.
And you mentioned something interesting. You know, we drive to work. This side often has all this exposure, yeah, and that shows up in cancer rates. Can you explain that?
Yes, very curious that when melanomas occur in the arms in the U.S. and some of the Western countries, it occurs on the left side. In countries where the driver is driving on the right side, it occurs mm-hmm. on the right side of the body. And that, I think, really illustrates the importance of wearing sunscreen on a daily basis, even when you're driving.
May I ask, not to put you on the spot, did you use sunscreen?
As an adult, I did.
Uh-huh.
When I was a kid, I was outside all the time, and I did not.
As far as the risk for men versus women, why is it higher?
I think it may have to do with the fact that men are often more exposed to the sun. I don't think there is a gender issue necessarily, although that could be as well. But I think it may be related more to men being more outdoors. They work outdoors. They're more exposed to outdoors. And maybe they don't wear as much sunscreen as women do. Women in general are more careful with their health.
And if you're Hispanic, African American, the rules are the same, right, as far as sunscreen?
Yeah, the rules apply to everyone. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the more melanin you have in your skin, the darker your skin, more protected you are, because the melanin actually quenches the ultraviolet light, and that's the function of melanin. So, but here in Florida, I have seen melanoma in all shades of skin, so it is not completely protective.
Right.
In African Americans, for example, the more common site of melanoma tends to be in the palms and soles, and that's a different type of melanoma that really needs to be taken care of early.
Richard, if I can ask, how are you doing today, and what is your message to everybody watching?
Well, I'm feeling great today, and actually going through the immunotherapy because it wound up boosting my own immune system and allowing it to fight the cancer. I did not have any symptoms all the way through it. Mm. It was actually kind of funny because Dr. Lutzky asked me about halfway through it if I had any rashes, and I said no. And he had asked me if I had any digestional issues, and I said no. And he had then asked me about fatigue. And I said, yeah. I said, our neighborhood put on a benefit for the Wounded Warrior Project about a week and a half ago. And when I got off that 5K run, I was a little tired.
Oh, my.
So he put a big grin on and said, okay, I don't need to ask you those questions anymore. So I actually felt good all the way through it. And the thing that I would say for any men, if you feel something on your skin, speak up. See a dermatologist right away.
Yeah, I think that's a great message for all of us. I thank you both for joining us. I think we learned a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And for more on protecting your skin, visit the Skin Cancer Foundation at skincancer.org, or you can check out our Facebook page at Your South FL.